One of the things I really enjoy about doing this show is the chance it gives me to spend some time with my old friends, like this next friend whose distinctive guitar sound I never get tired of listening to, the inventor of twang, ladies and gentlemen, Duane Eddy. Now, Duane, you are a member of both the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and the Musicians Hall of Fame.
This is true.
But you're a country boy at heart, right?
I am. I grew up listening to, Hank Williams, Lefty Frizzell, of course, George Jones, Webb Pierce.
And you grew up where?
I grew up in Arizona, mostly. I was born back in New York State.
That's
upstate
what I was,
New York.
I was thinking New York. But
yeah, Corning, New York, to be exact, and where they make the glass works, and where they have the glass works and make the glass.
Yeah, Corning. Everybody's got Corningware at home.
Yeah, my dad got sick of shoveling snow, so he said, I want to go somewhere warmer. So I was about 12 then, 11 or 12. I said, I want to go to Arizona and see the Cowboys and Indians, you know?
Right.
Never did see him, but we did go to Arizona.
So you're the guy that talked your dad into moving to Arizona? Is that true? I
mean, yeah.
And you met Lee Hazelwood out there, right?
Yeah, my dad managed Safeway stores, and he worked up the assistant manager in Tucson, where we first went, and then they gave him his own store in a little town called Coolidge. So we moved up there, and they had a little radio station, and Lee Hazelwood had just gotten out of Columbia Broadcasting School, I think it was. And they try to place their DJs, and they placed him in Coolidge.
Well, now tell the audience about the significance of your relationship with Lee Hazelwood. Tell them who Lee Hazelwood is in the first place, because I know who he is, but a lot of people might not.
Yeah, a lot of people don't. He became my producer in 1957, late 57, and produced and co-wrote all my hit songs that I did in 58 and 59 and 60 and 61, 62. And he went on to work with Nancy Sinatra. He wrote These Boots Are Made for Walking.
Pretty talented guy.
Yeah.
Nice guy to hook up with.
Yeah. But at the time he was a DJ, and what was great about his producing is he'd sit there in the radio station and listen to all those records, and he'd memorize the sounds of the bass, the drums, the keyboard. So when he went in to make records, he'd memorize.
He knew what to listen
he
for.
He knew what to he wanted on the sound.
Yeah. Listen, what kind of guitar did you develop your unique style on?
One just like this, except instead of Duane Eddy.
That says Duane Eddy there on the pick guard. It said
what? Chet Atkins. Because it was 1957, and I went into the Ziggy's music store there in Phoenix and bought, paid $17.50 a month.
I'm telling you, the Chet Atkins Gretsch guitar back then was the hot guitar, and they were the most expensive guitar probably.
Because I had a white falcon on the wall that was about $750.
Oh.
This was $450.
Oh.
And
none of my friends could afford it.
But the reason I wanted it mostly, besides being, I love Chet, but the reason I had it, we had the wang bar, the vibrato on it. And that's what I didn't have that on my 54 Gibson gold top.
Bigsby is the name I remember.
Bigsby.
And there it is right there. Bigsby.
Yeah.
Show us how that goes. I love it. Woo! Here we go again. Duane's going to do that song that was in that movie, Forrest Gump. You remember that movie where Forrest is running down that driveway and these mean boys are chasing him in a pickup truck, and he turns, cuts left out of that driveway and jumps the fence and starts running down the football field. And then everybody's saying, run, Forrest, run. Well, that song was Duane Eddy's Rebel Rouser. Duane Eddy, ladies and gentlemen.